All right, it's time now for a look at what's making news around the world with Dipti Gaur-Laurent. Dipti, you're starting with the reaction to Emmanuel Macron's speak to U.S. Congress in Washington.
That's right, Will. After the whining and dining, the hand-holding, the cheek-kissing and the public grooming, Emmanuel Macron gave a speech to Congress yesterday. Interestingly, it was day for day the 58 years since his idol Charles de Gaulle gave a speech to U.S. Congress. So there was a bit of symbolism there. For Le Figaro, the conservative paper, it was a friendly but critical speech. The French president put aside the bromance to tackle Donald Trump's policies, really positioning himself as an incarnation of an enlightened liberalism. I'm quoting Le Figaro there. The anti-model to Donald Trump, in a way. That's what the Le Figaro's editors say. Congress was seduced, but will Macron's strategy pay off? Well, we'll certainly find out when Donald Trump makes a decision on the Iran nuclear deal that expires next month.
Yeah, that's right, on May 12th. Now, you've also sent some reactions following one of Denmark's most high-profile murder trials.
Well, this murder trial really gripped Denmark. Peter Madsen, a reclusive inventor, has been handed down a life prison sentence, this over the sexual assault and murder of a Swedish journalist, Kim Wall, who died on his submarine last summer. It was one of Denmark's most gruesome murder cases. Her body was found mutilated, and in Madsen's version of events, it was an accidental death.
Numerous version of events.
Numerous really. Versions, because he did indeed change his story many times. Well, this is a Danish tabloid, Ekstrabladet, which says on its front page, welcome, Mr. Madsen, this is your new life, a new life in prison. Kim Wall's portrait is also making the front page of the British daily The Guardian, as you see here. Journalist's killer gets life, it says, and the British paper actually explains that Madsen's 11-day trial was spread over 7 weeks, and it gripped Denmark so much that courts opened a special room with video links so people could follow the trial.
Moving on now, but staying in Europe, there are more problems for Spanish leader Mariano Rajoy after Madrid's regional president resigned, this under, I would have to say, somewhat peculiar circumstances.
Not exactly the typical reason for resigning. Cristina Cifuentes was the president of Madrid's regional parliament. She's been forced to resign over a humiliating scandal, a video surfacing of her allegedly stealing two tubs of face cream 7 years ago. That's right, a very humiliating scandal.
Value of, I think, was 40 euros?
Exactly, not very much, but in symbolism, it's cost her career, so it was a very expensive theft. It comes, in fact, hot on the heels of another scandal engulfing Cifuentes, who was accused earlier of forging her master's degree. And with this face cream stealing incident now, it appears that it's a nail in the coffin for her career, at least for the Spanish version of Huffington Post. It's the last lie for Cifuentes. In this article, the director of Huffington Post, the Spanish version, says, "We don't know if she's a kleptomaniac, but we do know that she's a compulsive liar. This time, not even Mariano Rajoy, the Spanish leader, could find an excuse. Like Cesar, he lowered his thumb and Cifuentes resigned." Now, I like that imagery there from the Huffington Post. For the editors at El País, her resignation comes too late and really done in a bad way. Her downfall, nonetheless, should serve as an example for what happens when you pollute the name of politics.
Well, moving on from Spain's stealing scandal to Germany's anti-Semitism row, which has forced organizers to cancel a prestigious music awards ceremony. This really creating a scandal of the past week, hasn't it?
Exactly. Well, and we spoke yesterday about the anti-Semitism debate here in France. Well, now in Germany, the equivalent of their Grammy Awards, let's say, was embroiled in a scandal. This year, they awarded, it's called the Echo Awards. They awarded a rap duo an Echo Prize for their album entitled Young, Brutal and Good Looking 3. It sold over 200,000 copies in the country. The problem is that the rappers that you see here, Kollega and Farid Bang, have been accused of misogynistic, homophobic and anti-Semitic lyrics. In one of their songs, for instance, without going into too much detail, they compare their bodies to that of Holocaust prisoners. Now, the prize has prompted other artists to hand back their awards in protest, and now Bild, the German tabloid, reports that in a rather extraordinary move, the Federal Music Industry Association, who organize these events, have said they'll scrap future Echo Award ceremonies, saying, I quote, "The Echo brand is so badly damaged that a completely new beginning is now necessary."
Yeah, one of the rappers apologizing, but it seems, as you say, that the brand is damaged. They're moving on there. Well, finally, from Deep D, South and North Korean leaders meeting on the border tomorrow for a historic summit. Ahead of that, though, the choice of dessert for tomorrow's meal is prompting some outrage. Tell us why.
Well, I'm sure you want to know what that dessert is, first of all.
Always concerned about dessert.
It's a mango mousse. And as The Telegraph, the British daily, says, this mango mousse has exposed the delicate dessert diplomacy of the North and South Korea summit. In fact, this time involving Japan, because as you see on that dessert proposed for tomorrow's summit, it features a map of the Korean peninsula that includes disputed islands with Japan. So now Japan's foreign minister has said it's extremely regrettable. Tokyo has even lodged a protest demanding that this dessert is not served. Tensions between Seoul and Tokyo date back to events from the Second World War. But after Trump's diplomacy by dandruff and now diplomacy by dessert, maybe we should just stick to the good old basics.
Yeah, let's not get our geography from a mango. We could go wrong with the roundup of the headlines.